and placing all the models properly and putting all the materials, what we will do, we will render it and we will create some walkthrough in Revit. So let me show you how we can do that. So for that, go to this view tab, and here you have this presentation panel and you have this render option. Okay. So you can go for this render settings, specify the quality and output settings. You can go for the printer, and there you can mention it, the DPI, and accordingly you will get the pixel sizes. And if you are going with this screen, so as per the screen, you will get the resolution and lighting. Here you have selected the exterior sun only. So if you are providing the exterior output, exterior rendering, so you can go with this sun only. So if you are providing your day scene, so go with sun only. And if you are providing the sunset or evening scene, you can go with sun and artificial, so you'll get some natural light. And all the lights you have placed here, you can see some artificial lights also. And here you can go with this artificial only for your night scene. And similarly, you have for your interior, and similarly, you have the interior for natural lights and your artificial light. So you can choose among that. So let me show you that if you choose this artificial only, so you will get this artificial light settings. Okay, so all the lights, you can on it, you can off it from here. And right now, you just go to that and you can group them also. You can create a new light group also. So this thing, you can control it. And about the background, so let me choose this exterior sun only. So if you are providing natural lights, you cannot select that artificial light. Now you can provide the sun settings. So you can provide the lighting as per this, your position, sun position, you can place it. If you are going with any particular, so if you are providing this steel, so as per the location and date and time, you'll get it. In the AutoCAD, we have seen these things. So similarly, we can provide it, and as per some presets, so we have some presets accordingly, you will get some timing and location. You can define your location and the time, and time and date will define the sun intensity and sun position. Okay, so you can apply it and click on OK. That is done. And about the image exposure, image brightness and contrast, highlights, shadows, saturation, this thing you can control it. All right. And as because I am using 2021 version, so here you can get this graphic display here. And within this realistic, you will get some rendering effect. Okay, you can change all these things in this realistic also about the exposure. Okay, so that is set to automatic. You can click on this manual and you can change these values, and you can set the color correction. Okay, and for the background that is currently at none, you can apply some sky background. This is the ground color. Click on apply, and there you can see. Click on OK. And so this way it will work generally. We give you a background. So rather than choosing this background option, you can put go to this realistic here. Sorry, graphic display option, and from here you can choose this none option, or you can apply image. You can go for any particular image. Let me choose it. I'll select that image, click on OK. Apply, and there you can see, click on OK. And you can position your model like that and zoom it. Right. And here you have this image exposure option. You can go for that image exposure. So that will be the exposure control for your final output. Okay. And then go for the render. And we will render it. All right, everything is fine. Now let's go for render, and it will render it. Okay, so this is the render output. This is the render view. And you can see that within this rendering, I'm not getting that image, right? That image is applicable in the realistic mode only. I will show you how you can add image for your render output. Okay, so your rendering is done, and after that you will get these options activated: save to project, export. So you can export this rendering as an image file, and you can save it externally in your system, and you can save this in your project as a view, and you can show the model. This is the model, and you can show the rendering. Okay, and here within this background, here we have this image option, and here I will apply that image. Now let me apply this image. Okay, so we will go with this stretch option. You are already familiar with this option in AutoCAD. So now if you want the best, so you can go with the best. It will take time, okay? Okay, this way you can position it. And then go for render. And right now I have selected the best. So it will provide you with more quality, more accuracy. It will take time. The more quality you need, it will take more time to produce the best quality. Okay, so I can just simply go for this stop. Yes, let me stop it. And you can see that it's matching with the high quality even in this 4% of best, right? So this is the and here we can save it in the project and I can name it like the render in. Click on OK. And here you can see this is the rendering view which is created right now. Alright, so this one was the previous rendering and this is the current rendering which I have saved. Okay, and you can change the image size and all, you can change position and all. Okay, and also you can rename it again. After that, you can duplicate it, right? And you can go for save to a new file. From here, you can save it also. From here, if you save it, so the thumbnail preview will be the rendering and you can save your project file. So it will be saved as a project. And if you want to export this, it's not saved. And if you want to export this image, okay. So for that, again, go to your 3D view, go to that 3D view and come to this render. And again, go for the render. And then you have this export option. Select that, you will be able to export it as a JPG file. Okay. Let me show you that how we can place a particular camera. So I hope you remember in AutoCAD also we have placed a camera, right? So we can place cameras. Here we have the camera option. You can place the camera and we can create a particular position view. Okay, from a particular position we can get a view. So we can simply go to level one also. And from this position, I can create this camera. Okay, and I'm getting this camera view and I can change the field of view. So this is the field of view window. I can simply change. Okay, so this is the camera, and if you want to change the position, So you can go to the elevation also. From the elevation, you can change the height. And this is the target position, you know. You can change the target position also. Right. And there you can see this is the view right now. You can come here. You can change the camera position. And there you can see this is the view right now. Okay, so this way you can change field of view. This is the field of view. With this option, you can also change the field of view. You can come to 3D also. And from 3D also, you can change the camera position and all the direction you can change. Okay, and target position you can change. And accordingly, you will get that view. Okay. So this thing you have to work a lot to position the camera. Now I'll show you that how we can place path and we can create walkthrough. Okay. So for creating walkthrough, I will go to this level one. So from this, we'll create a walkthrough. Now let me place the first camera, then the second camera, third, and this way I will create the path. And the Revit place the offset at a eye level. Okay, so this is the general and default eye level. So you can change the eye level also. So let me change the eye level or the camera position at a height. All right. From level one, it will be calculated. If you want to change the position for level two right now, you can change the level two. And then you can go for level three as well. Or else you can change the offset from a particular level. Okay. And that is created. And after that, we will modify it and select it and go for edit walkthrough. And this is the first camera. And we will change the camera position and all. So let me change the camera position. Okay. So I'll select and I will see at this position. Sorry. Okay. With this grip, I will change. All right. Now at this point also, so just drag it and change this direction. Drag this camera and change the orientation. Drag this camera and change the orientation. So you have to set the orientation as per your requirement. Otherwise, Revit will create. and you can change the field of view as well. And for this camera also, you have this far clip and far clip offset, means how far you can see. All right, that option you have. So here you can change this far clip if you don't want to see any far objects, only the nearby objects. If you want to activate it, activate and there set the distance. Okay. So for this position, I can uncheck it. Okay, so it will uncheck for all the. Now we can just select this walkthrough, double click on it, and then select this. Okay, suppose we have mistakenly escaped from that walkthrough. So come to this walkthrough. This one will be created in your project browser. Select this walkthrough and this, then select this FOV window and then again come back to level one and go for edit walkthrough. And then we can edit the walkthrough. Let's select this power clip active. Let me change this position. So let's change it quickly. All right, so we have done it. And then we can play it, you can see. Right, and then you can change the elevation height also if you need. So you can go to any particular elevation there, and there you can see this is the. Okay, sorry, click on this edit walkthrough, and then for each frame you can change the position. Okay, so. You can just simply change this direction at one frame, and then for the next, you can click on this next frame, so it will go to the next frame. For each frame, you can set it, okay? And you can come back to the previous frame. So you can just go for each frame wise 1, 2, 3 until 300, or else you can just switch to next keyframe. So it will switch to the next keyframe, that is 10.9. So these red dots are the keyframe positions, and you can change from that. Can change, okay. And if you want to change the height, so you have to. Click on this while creating that camera, you had to place the offset, okay, where you had to mention. And now you can just here you have to click on this control path. Now you can change the path height and all. You can change the height and all. Okay, you can change the height of your path. So here you have the control. You can add more keyframes also. If you want to add any keyframe there, if you want to remove any keyframe, so you can remove it. All right. So that we can do it. And after that, here we have this frame option. If you want to add more frames, you can add more frames. And for all these frames, we'll get the equal speed, uniform speed. So if you don't want uniform speed, so for any particular keyframe, you can speed it up, you can speed it down, you can decrease the speed. And as for this frame, you will get the total second. Here you can see, if you go for uniform speed, you can see the frame per second is 15 per second frame. You can go with the one only, one frame per second. All right, then click on apply, and you can see this is the total time, 300 second. Okay, and here you can see that it's taking that much of time. All right, and that is all. And here also you get the walkthrough frame option, the same option. Here you can increase the total frame number, right? And here you see this is the walkthrough. This is the walkthrough window. You can change. Just need to set the camera properly. Let me go to this edit walkthrough, and now let me go for this play. Here you can see it's just playing all around. Okay, so for the far clip offset, I will go for 5 feet. Click on apply, and now you can see that I cannot see far from 5 feet. Okay, after 5 feet, I cannot see anything. So here you have to provide that far clip offset. And I'm seeing something. So this will include or exclude some objects from your scene. All right, and you can position it, and after that you can export this as a video. So for that we have this export option. Then just place your mouse on this arrow. Then you have this images and animation. Select this walkthrough and output length, all frames. You want to export all the frames. This is the frame per second, as we have mentioned. and this is a visual style. You can choose realistic or rendering. We can include the rendering, so it will render and create the walkthrough. Okay, and this is the dimension, and this is zoom to 6% of actual size. You can decrease it, and everything is fine. And if you want to include time and date stamp, you can include that, and you can click on OK. And here you can customize, like from any particular frame to particular frame. You want to render it, you can go for the frame range, and there you can mention. You will go with all frame. That is okay. And let me save it on my desktop. All right. And within this Revit, I will save it. Click on this option and everything is fine. And this is will be saved in AVI format if I want a video format, or if I want JPG for all the frames. So I can choose this, and as a bitmap or PNG files, GIF files, I can choose these file types. So let me click on save, and it will save all the frames. So here you can compress it. I can choose Microsoft Video and the compression quality. Here you can mention, click on OK. And, you can go for configure. Everything is fine. Shake it, click on OK. And it will start rendering your walkthrough. It will take time.
So,
yes.
So you were just when you are going through this walkthrough, you were just selecting hardly 10 to 15 cameras, but when it converting in this walkthrough, there is 300 frames. How?
300 frames. So I have placed the cameras on key positions only. So suppose I have placed my cameras one at the point 1 and at the point 10, and then yeah, next is at the 20. Okay, this way I have placed. So in between the cameras are placed, in between the cameras are placed, so the camera positions will be set automatically as per the key positions. Okay. I can position all the points. For all the points, I can position it, but it will take lots of time. And this is not our department. For this, the visualization team are there to create all these walkthroughs and all. So just if you are doing any freelancing work, you can do it by your own. So you can go for more details. So for that, you can position all the cameras for particular frames. You can make it a stunning walkthrough with that. But for our session, I have just showed you that these are the options to show you quickly. Okay, so it will create like this way, and rendering is processed. So I have already created one for a demo. Let me load that. Let me see if I have it. Can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
The video is visible, right?
Yes.
Yes. So this is the rendering which we have created from Revit. The walkthrough from Revit. You can show it from the interiors as well. There you have to create your path, your camera positions. All right, I hope you understand. Okay, so this is all for today.